Learn what Azure DevOps projects are and how to use them with Node.js and Kubernetes in this episode of Azure Tips and Tricks. Here in the Azure portal, you see the Azure DevOps project that we've created in the first video. We've already looked at the code repository and the build process. Let's look at the release process. That is this one here. This takes us to the Azure DevOps portal, where we can also find the code repository and the builds. This is the release definition, and we can see that it is deployed successfully to the dev stage. Let's edit it to see which steps it contains. In this designer, we can see that it contains a drop stage, which receives the artifacts from the build and automatically triggers the release. It releases to just one stage, which is the dev stage. Let's take a look. These are the steps that the dev stage goes through to deploy the Azure resources and the application. As you can see, these steps do all sorts of things, from setting Azure tags on resources to deploying containers to Kubernetes. A release pipeline like this, together with a build pipeline, is a very powerful tool that you can use to automatically deploy your infrastructure and application. Let's go back to the Azure portal. Here are the resources that contain a URL to the live application and to the Kubernetes service. I'll click on the link to the external application. This opens the sample node.js application. It is up and running. And back here, we also have the link to the Kubernetes cluster that is running the application. This is the Azure Kubernetes service. This runs the containers that run the application and orchestrates them. This is a really cool service because it takes care of the orchestration for me. I don't have to be a container orchestration expert to use it. All right, let's go back. The final resource is Application Insights. This is a powerful analytics tool, and this one is coupled to the application. This records the usage and performance of the application and shows things like failures as well. This is very useful when you are continuously releasing and tracking how the application performs after each release. The last thing that I want to show you are the resource groups that are created in this process. In total, there are 3 resource groups that contain all of the resources. The names will be different when you do this yourself. The first group contains the resources that the Azure Kubernetes service runs on. And as you can see, there are a lot of them. The second group contains the resources for the container registry and Application Insights, and the Azure Kubernetes service itself. And the final group contains the Azure DevOps project, and in my case, the reference to the Azure DevOps organization. By using Azure DevOps projects, we've deployed an app to Azure using our language of choice, deployed the app using Kubernetes and ACR, and set up the build and release pipelines in minutes compared to the hours this would normally take you. Go check it out.